Hold up. Let's get it. Yeah. We back at it, baby. All right, we're going to call this High Financial Literacy. Let me see what strand I want to smoke on real quick. I got four different strands. Shout out to everybody, man. So we're going to talk about the stock market. We might even look at some stocks. You know, we're going to get into it. Let me smell these first. Let me see what strand I want to smoke. Not that one. I want to smoke some of that new stuff. Yep, here we go. First try. So I'm going to smoke this one. All right. So first, let me get this right real quick. Let me see. We'll use this bad boy. It's about to go down. All right. So we're going to be smoking on a classic Sour Diesel. And let's see how many financial literacy thoughts we can come out with. Shout out to all my followers and my supporters, man. All right. I'm personally an advocate of marijuana. I am. I love it. And when you love something, you can capitalize from. By the way, I am an investor of marijuana. So yes, I actually own the weed I smoke. Shout out to Viola. So yes, I am an investor in Viola. I put in 100K 3 years ago. So yes, I am 100K deep into marijuana. And my 100K will be worth millions in 10 years. So shout out to Al Harrington and the Viola brand for letting me invest in them. And yes, I actually own a share of the weed I smoke. So for all of you like, are you making money? Yes, I am. Not yet though, it's coming in the future. So yes, I am an investor in weed, in legal weed too. So that means I can call up anytime I want and get free zips, free anything. Now granted, I paid 100K for it 3 years ago, but you get the point. Yeah, this shit about to go down. All right, y'all. So, I'm going to just tell y'all something before we keep going. I don't really smoke papers or blunts anymore. I smoke out of a mini bowl because I don't really like firing just straight gas. I like to filter the gas through water. You feel me? So I haven't smoked a blunt or a paper in months. In about a month and a half. It's almost 2 months. By the way, my birthday is on the 12th of April. So I turn 27 in 7 days. In a week. 7 days from now, I'll be 27 years old. And I'm going to explain something to y'all. The reason why. I'll explain this too. I used to be the young guy, but now that I'm approaching 27, like now I'm getting older. You feel me? Like I'm no longer young R, so I can't milk the whole young nigga getting money shit no more. I can't really do that no more. But, you know, that's a good thing because now I got to transition into a different, a different age group. So I've been thinking about that lately. I've been thinking about like, you know, damn, I'm about to transition into the old niggas now. Now I got to start. Maybe I got to put on a suit now. Like I'm about to be 27. I might have to wear a tie now. I might have to wear a tie. What else old people do when they 27? I probably got to tuck in my shirt. Get me a pair of New Balances. I probably got to learn how to grill now. You know? So I've been thinking about that. I'm like, damn. I might have to start learning how to grill food, Get me a pair of New Balances. Start tucking in my shirt. I'm about to be 27. You know? So and they said, now you gotta pull your pants up. It's about time to get that finger in my ass, ain't it? Hey, what we turn about 40 or 50? You gotta go to the doctor and get the finger up your ass. Like, that's like 15 years from now. Like, I'm scared. No, you know, pause, but I'm just thinking about all that. Like, damn, all that shit coming. You know? So yeah, man. So all the 90s babies, we getting old. We getting old, you feel me? Is that LeBron? But anyways, man. Yeah, I think I'm going to die before I get that shit. Somebody said, I'm too high for that comment. They said, bro, can't wait for the prostate exam. Boy, you stupid as hell, boy. You still young, fam? Yeah, I am. I was born in 96, though. 1996. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. You feel me? I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I was born in 96. I am an Olympic baby. So, ever since I moved back to Atlanta, let me tell you what happened. I moved back to Atlanta in 2020. I left Atlanta in 2013. I was gone for about 7 years. I come back home. The motherfucking Georgia Bulldogs win it twice. Atlanta Braves win it. Financial literacy get bought to the city. So, hey, I'm Atlanta's good luck charm. Now we up. Ever since the king has returned home, now we up. You feel me? So, I just want to say that, Atlanta, the king is home. And, you know, we winning now. We back at it. Your good luck charm is back. I'm an Olympic baby, 1996, ATL. I was at the Olympics, but I was only months old. Yeah, I only took two hits. That's the point. We on the real one. Look, something about me, y'all. I smoked the one, not the two. So everybody who don't understand this, your weed, man, doesn't have the one. I'm smoking on the one. All right? I ain't smoking on the two. Meaning what I'm smoking, for one, paying premium price. You feel me? I'm paying at least $400 to $500 a zip. You feel me? If you ain't even charging premium price, I don't want it. You know what I'm saying? I don't want your spray weed. I don't want none of that. I'm smoking on the one. I get what I want and the strand I want. So that's something you gotta understand about me. When you're looking at me, I ain't smoking on the 3, 4, 5 like some of you are. I'm smoking on the one. Alright? So these thoughts are generated from the one, not the two. So I'm gonna continue. So I'll find up the what? Shit. Let me get a good hit of this real quick. This man just said the comment I pinned on Instagram. He just said, why does it matter? It's all the same high. That's not true. But let's get into these financial literacy museums, folks. So, you know, I always tell y'all, what, for one, ask me a question on IG. Ask me a question, for one. Anything. I'm just going to answer y'all questions. I'm going to flow off y'all energy. What would you like to know from me? And I'll answer it. I like to flow off y'all energy. Somebody said, not true. See, weed smokers don't like. Yeah. He said the 3, 4, 5 gonna give you a mean ass headache, big fat emperor crew. Talk about currency. What's the best book to read? Right here, folks. Check out IG Live. Hold up. So you see those right there? Take a screenshot, cuz. See, here's the thing. People be gatekeeping this shit because they say if you want to keep something from a man, put it in a book. So I'll literally tell you the books I'm gonna read, cuz guess what you're not gonna do? You're not gonna read them. All right? So that's the thing about all of this. Even if you read all of these books, you still got to go execute it. So I'm not afraid to tell you what books I read, because guess what? You're not going to read them. So, and that's a true statement. They say if you want to keep something from a man, put it in a book. So I can literally tell you every book I read. I don't have to gatekeep. Because I read all those books. I read all 700 pages. A lot of people not going to read them. I can literally say I read all of this. And you're going to be like, cool, cool, cool. And they ain't going to read them. You get what I'm saying? Not all of you. Some of you will. But I'm saying majority, 90% on this live is not about to go read those books. All right. And that's why they say if you want to keep something from a man, put it in a book. This is not some shit I made up. This is some shit they've been knowing since the 1940s. This saying is probably 100 years old, what I just said. 1920s. If you want to keep something from a man, put it in a book. So y'all mad at me, don't get mad at me. Don't hate the player, hate the game. That's not my saying. This is some shit your grandma said before, your uncle said before. Alright? Don't blame me. This is an old saying. The gems are in the book. I ain't even gonna lie. I ain't gonna read them books, RC. Cuz keeping it real, goddamn, you feel me? Like, hey, that's the shit I like, cuz. You see how cuz was like, hey, cuz, but I'll show you again, cuz, just in case you ever feel motivated to do it again. But cuz kept it real. Look at the comment I pinned. Cuz kept it real. That's what I like. He is not about to read this shit. He is not. And he said, bro, kept it a book. Real shit, though. He said, you right, bro. Somebody said, reading is essential. People on live said, you right. Rich Dad, Poor Dad is a must read. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is, my brother. I'll answer a question from YouTube now. YouTube, ask me a question. I'm going to go back and forth. I'm going to answer a question from YouTube, and I'm going to answer a question from Instagram, since we live on both. YouTube, ask me a question. Let's get it. And we're going to pin it to the top. Let me see if y'all already did. Let's see. I'll let y'all ask some more, just in case it's an educated question. But I'll go ahead and just go ahead and go back and forth. This person said, who is this? Julian Williams said, what computer do you buy to get started trading? So, let me give you the lie. See, I'm already high. I was choosing the wrong phone. So, you can buy two screens, brother. Look at the IG Live. So, you can buy two screens, brother. But I don't use these screens because I'm a traveler. So, I'm not really stationary like that. So it's kind of like, how do I say it? I only trade on these, my laptop, my, this secondary monitor. And, you know, I don't like to trade on these because I don't want my brain to get used to these big screens. So today I made this. Let me see. Oh shit, wrong one. It ain't on this thing. I made 4,500. Actually, I can show you. I'll show you live on my actual account. Watch this. I'll show you right here. All right. So this is what I made today. I made in my small account, I made $1,200 in this account. But I use these though. I use these computers to make that. I didn't use this big ass screen right here to make these. So I'm just letting you know that it's possible. So we go to another account. Hold up. And then let me show you what I made in there. All right. So let me not show my balance real quick. All right, here. Boom. So you see I made $4,500. So I made $1,200 in one account and $4,500 in the other. You see that? So I made $1,200 in one account and $4,500 in the other. So I don't know. You can add that up. That's think or swim. So I possibly made about $5,700, something like that, trading stocks with that. All right, let's see another question. What else question y'all got? How often do you sports bet? Every day. What is the app you're using? I'm using Thinkorswim. Whoever asked this, I'm using Thinkorswim. Let me see what else y'all said in the YouTube comments. Let's see. Okay, this is a good one. This Tiana Tania said on YouTube, I am always conflicted on paying off debt first or padding my investment account and or trading account. Can't be done in tandem as a tool to make money to pay off debt. So can it be done as a tandem? I would say pay those folks off the minimum you can. Do not try to fall into the middle class trap of trying to call yourself debt free. Okay. So the only reason you probably want to pay off debt is to say you're debt free. But guess what? When the government owes you money, they pay you back when they want to. So pay them back when you want to, but pay the minimum payments and invest in yourself. Because if you invest in yourself, you'll be able to pay them back fully one day. But how can you be up if you're trying to spend all of your money trying to say you're debt free? Because once you post it on Instagram, no one really cares. The moment you tell Instagram, hey, you guys, I'm debt free, they're going to scroll to the next reel and not care whether you're debt free or not. You get what I'm saying? So people's attention spans are so low. So if I were you, focus on you, because you have no other reason to say you're debt free other than I'm debt free. It's just a saying. Stay in debt. Pay them off with the minimum payments. Invest all money into yourself. All right. Let's see what the next question is. Yes, pay the minimum. Who gives a fuck about the interest? If you think about it, so this person said, so you don't really care about the interest on your debt since you saying pay the minimum. So this is what I'm saying. I pinned this on Instagram. So think about it, bro. Like, if you can end up paying them back fully if you get the money first. You got to go get the money first. How can you pay these folks back if you ain't up? So why would you, as soon as you get some money, pay them, try to just pay them back fully? Nah, hell nah. Because either way, that balance is still there. Yes, it's going up with interest, but who cares? I'd rather go get $1 million first and then go pay back $100K in student loans. That's just me. You know what I'm saying? That's how I think. You get what I mean? Don't pay off no car note hold. Don't pay off no cat. Don't pay off no household. That's the worst financial mistake you can make, especially if you middle class, because cash is king. So you're forfeiting all of your cash to the banks, and now you have nothing to invest into yourself. So now you're back to square one. And then I know what you're saying. Well, once I pay them off, I could just save money from there. Fuck that. Go get yours first. You deserve to get your money first.
They deserve to get there last because they had an advantage. These folks literally colonized some stolen land and making up rules for you to follow. So who gives a fuck about paying them back first? They stole first. So why do you care about stealing? This shit ain't fair. The system they putting you through is some shit they made up in the first place. You get what I'm saying? We used to be on a barter system. Now we trading currencies and cash. And then the people who created the rules already billionaires and millionaires because you the one printing the money. So they already up. Who gives a fuck? Don't pay them folks back first. Pay yourself back first. Fuck them folks. Fuck the banks. Fuck the student loans. Fuck the university. Fuck them folks. They'll get it when you got it. But pay back the minimum. You know, don't let shit get bad on your credit. Nothing like that. But fuck them folks. Let's see. For someone like myself who considering taking a personal loan, this person said, for someone like myself who's considering taking a personal loan of $120,000 with zero interest rate for 12 to 15 months with a 60 to 80 month term for my music, what's one way to double that back in investments? I mean, dog, you really about to go spend $120,000? So you got the opportunity to take out a $120,000 loan and you're going to invest it in your music. This is a comment from YouTube. Because I love you, brother, I'm not going to tell you don't follow your dreams. But sometimes plan B got to make plan A work. You feel me? So I know you want to do music, but you might have to do plan B real quick so music can work. Because it costs a lot more than $120,000 to get up on some music. Costs a lot more. It costs millions to make millions. It costs $100,000 to make millions. If you're trying to become if you're trying to become a millionaire off rapping, think about how they make their money. They make their money off tours. Not streams, not YouTube, not this and that, but tours. You're better off investing into your social media account than investing into some rap career or all this other shit. You better off going viral on TikTok. If I were you, I would figure out a way to do it with the least amount of overhead. And I would save that $120,000 that you're able to get and think very smart about how I'm gonna flip it. That's the first thing you gotta do, is think very smart about how you're going to flip this $120,000. You got $120,000. If you can't become a millionaire with 120 racks, you weren't meant to be one. I'm gonna let everybody know that. If you can't, if you got six figures on you, and you somehow some, now I ain't gonna lie. If you get caught up in your lifestyle, that can happen. And then, you know, some people can, you know, be like, fuck it. But I'm letting you know, like, you got 120 racks. You are 12% there. You are 12% a millionaire. You got 90. You got 98% to go. I mean, my fault, 88%. You got 88% to go. So now you got to figure out, how can I turn this shit up 88%? But what it starts with is getting 1% better every day. So just try to generate 1% of that 120,000 every day. That's number one. Figure out how you can get 1% better and richer every day. That's the real goal. And calculate it based off your income. What can you generate per year? Now, how can I get 1% of this to invest back into myself? And after 100 days of getting back 1%, I am at 100%. I have flipped my money. So let's just say I make $100 a year. So you guys don't have to do too much math. If I get a dollar every day for 100 days, that's 1% better every day. So that's how you determine your 1% out of 100. So if you get 1% better every day, after 100 days, you're up 100% better. After 200 days of making 1%, you are now 200% better. You get what I'm saying? After 300 days of getting back that 1%, you have now flipped your income 3 times. It's how this shit go. It's how this shit go. Somebody said, we all need that bong. I love it. He said, we all need that bong. Let me hit it again. I told y'all, when this gas hit, it's a wrap. Oof. That's him. That's the one. But yo. All right, let's get it. Oof. Somebody said, yeah, you definitely smoking the one. Damn. My goddamn fucking YouTube camera came off again. Goddamn motherfucker. You know what? We can switch it. Boom. We got the FaceTime camera now. Yeah. YouTube thought they had me. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get 2 cameras now. I know what to do. Yeah, I just thought of something. I turn on that on the FaceTime camera. So let me wipe that off. Make sure y'all can see. Yeah, we back in motion, baby. So I'm gonna go get me a webcam camera. I'm gonna hook up the webcam camera next time, and then we just gonna switch the views. See how quick I act. So let's get into it now. I appreciate the feedback. Means a lot. You're welcome, brother. And I'll pin that. You are so welcome, my brother. Let's see on breakdown interest on payments with only paying the minimum. Do the interest build up every month, or are you just paying the minimum? Well, you got to think over if you have a loan that is 7%. This is how I would say, the longer you prolong paying off a loan, the interest will hit. So yes, the interest will hit, but you gotta think, which one would you rather take the risk on? Would you rather take the risk on being debt, being financially free or debt free? So you got cash, so you need cash to invest in yourself. So this is how I feel, bro. You need cash to invest in yourself. Cash is cash flow. So you got to live off one stream of income, and then you got to invest the other. So the other stream of income is your cash flow. So if you're investing your cash flow into paying somebody back because it's a student loan or a loan or anything, and you're trying to pay that off cash, this cash flow was supposed to go into securing your financial future first. You get what I'm saying? So investment one will be your job. Investment two will be your side hustle or second job. You live off one and then you stick with it, but then you invest two. So everybody here has the chance to come up with just 2 streams of income. I keep saying this 1,000,000 times. This is my logic. You know how Robert Kawasaki got Rich Dad, Poor Dad? And you know how goddamn Napoleon Hill got Think and Grow Rich? 2 streams of income is Aristotle's. That's my shit. And risk management, A+ setups, discipline, patience. I could really go patent these things. These are my teachings. That is how you power up, folks. All of you. Even if you broke, even if you poor, I don't care who you are. Even if you drive Uber, all you need is 2 streams of income. Live off one, invest the other. And all of you can get lit. All of you can. Every last one of you on this live, you can get lit. quickly. So when I speak from a place of I know how this shit goes because I did it. When I tell y'all that two streams of income shit, it's not because I read it from some book. It's not because nothing. It's because that's how I got lit. I was a barber in the military. I lived off my military income and I invested and saved 100% of my barber income. But I worked every day. I worked every single day. And that's the honest truth. So I'm telling you something that I did personally. This isn't some shit that I discovered from back in the day. This ain't none of that. This is like raw fact. This is what I did. I lived off my army money, invested my barber money. That's all you got to do, but you got to be all money in. And guess what? That shit got to work too. I ain't going to lie. The second thing you do got to work. So you got to find two things that work. And that's the only way you can get lit. I'm being honest with you. You got to find two things that work. I give you two. Uber works. Uber actually works. That's one. That's an easy stream of income. DoorDash work too. We ordering that food every day. What else work? A second job. What else work? Photography. Go take people pictures. You know what else work? Filming people content and editing their content and putting their social media on autopilot. Y'all see everybody want to be an influencer, but you don't want to capitalize on this market. It's the dumbest thing I ever heard. If I was to fall off, if y'all want to know what I would be, I'd just go turn up somebody's Instagram. If I was to fall off tomorrow, you know what I'm going to be? A damn video editor, content creator, content editor for somebody. Managing their social media. I will be something social media. It's the easiest bag. All right, what do you do to stay motivated? Love myself. People want you to hate yourself. So if you asking me what I do to stay motivated, I love myself. People gonna try every day to make you hate yourself. So being arrogant is actually something that I recommend doing, because if you don't love yourself, you will be forced to hate yourself. You don't have to be arrogant as the words you speak, but the thoughts you think. You get what I'm saying? So the word what's outside should not be, you should be humble on the outside, but on the inside, you should be extra arrogant. You should love yourself. You should love the skin you have. You should love your teeth. You should love your hair. You should love everything about you, because we all have flaws. So that's step number one, loving yourself. I do this shit for me. If y'all want to know why I do this shit, why I wake up every single day and get money, it's because it's for my legacy. I love myself. I ain't doing this shit. People always say, I do this for my family. Yeah, that's part of it. Part of it is motivation that, you know, I don't want to let my family down, but hell nah, that ain't why I'm doing this. You know why people do this shit? Because they love themselves and their story. Your life is a book. So you got to decide how you want this book to be written. You feel me? That's what you got to decide. You got to decide, how would I like my book to be written? So while you live on this earth, write the best book you can. Do you want in your book, you are a snake? You get what I'm saying? See, when you see, I want my book to be cool and I have integrity. So I want my book to be cool to me, not the shit I say. So I got integrity with who I am. The reason why I'm able to be me is because I actually have integrity with trying to be me on and off the camera. See, some people try to, the reason why they can't do it, because you're trying to be it on the camera, but then when you turn off the camera, it ain't you. This is me. So I care about my legacy. I care about the way I view my story. But it's about me. It's a selfish attitude. And if you don't have that mindset, the world will try to take it from you and make sure you don't have it. Because everyone is scared of people who have that mindset. It threatens them. People hate to see somebody strive to be better than them. It takes a form of isolation. You got to be comfortable with being with just you, yourself, and I. So because I isolated myself with all of this, I'm in the trenches, bro. I'm working like solo dolo. It gave me a sense of I can keep going no matter what. All I got to do is just pay attention to the man in the mirror, and this shit easy work. But see, what happens is your energy get thrown off when you paying attention to everybody else. I'm telling you what's going on. You got to zone out and just stick and just focus on you for some years, bro. You can get back to people. Them same people who you trying not to miss out on, they'll be there in 2 years. They'll be there in 2 years, bro. They'll understand, but this shit got to be personal. You got to love yourself enough to want to do it for you. Don't even think about anybody else. If you hustle with horse blinders on, it's going to make it a lot easier. And that's one of the hardest things to do, is to not compare yourself. It's to not hustle with horse blinders on. And that be people's problem. They don't be so focused on their purpose. If you start focusing just on your purpose, it's going to be like, it's going to have a drive on you that you, but when you depend on others for your happiness, you shouldn't depend on nobody for your happiness. You should never let anyone have that power over you. Don't give nobody that much power. Because if you give people, that's a lot of power. You pretty much telling somebody, if you don't approve of who I am, then I don't want to try and I am nothing. When you decide not to try, you letting them win. That's a lot of power you giving other human beings over you. So I decided I would not let one person in this world determine my happiness but me. You get what I'm saying? That's why I tell people you can't be 100% in anything. You got to be 90, because you always got to save 10% for yourself. That's survival skills. It's only three people I die for in this world, and that's my wife and my two kids. Other than that, that's the only people I give 100% of my life to. You get what I mean? And that's how any man should feel. You can't just give everybody the power over you. You feel me? So, that's how you stay motivated, by not giving people power over you. And you do this for yourself, because you want a legacy for yourself. What do you want to do in life? Go fucking do it. Go try. Shoot for the stars. And if you land on the moon, that's okay. Strive for plan A, and I bet you'll get somewhere. You feel me? On some real shit. I bet if you strive for plan A, you'll get somewhere. And a lot of people don't realize that. So if you don't strive, you're just going to be stuck where you are if you don't try. So regardless, if you don't make it, at least you can look back at all the haters and say, motherfucker, I'm further than where I was when I started, though. I might not be actor number one, but motherfucker, I was on that film, and I was on this film, and I was on this film, and I met this connection, and I met this beautiful girl here. We got married. Now we making money in real estate. Yeah, I'm not the actor I wanted to be, but through me trying to strive for my dreams, I got somewhere. And guess what, motherfucker? You still here, and you ain't doing shit, and you still living off your old high school days. That's what you doing. That's what you could tell the motherfucker who don't want you to be what you want to be. You feel me? No matter, all you got to do is just try in life. And wherever you land, it's on you. But you got to think, if you didn't get to where you want to be, the one question you got to ask yourself was, did I give it my all? If the answer is no, then that shit is on you. And that's something I want people to understand. If you don't decide to give your all one day, you cannot be mad at the fucking bed you lay on. If you can't look yourself in your mirror, in the mirror, and say, I fucking tried. I read some books. I bought some courses. I did this. I did that. If you ain't doing that, I don't give a fuck what you talking about. You ain't fucking try. You don't deserve what the fuck you think you deserve. You don't fucking deserve it. If you ain't out here networking, if you ain't out here reading books, if you ain't out here actually giving it a fucking try, I don't care how much you hate on the next man. He deserves it. You don't, because he's trying and you're not. All you got to do is fucking try and you'll get somewhere. It's literally that simple. If you suck at saving money, fix saving money. You don't even know what's wrong with you. So many people can't even self-diagnose themselves because they're so narcissistic. Some people can't even identify what the fuck's wrong with them. And that be the problem. You don't even want to admit to your wrongs. You don't even want to accept the fact that whatever it is in your life is a fucking problem. You get what I'm saying? They don't even want to accept that fact. If it's a problem, fix it. Try to fix it. If you suck at getting money, learn about getting money. Surround yourself around people who get money. Read books about getting money. Take courses about getting money. Talk to people who got money. If you suck at getting girls, focus, research that shit. You suck at whatever it is, research. Literacy is how I learn anything. You can learn how to please a woman online. If you Google it, you can be good at anything if you research it. And the fucked up part about it is, everybody got an iPhone, YouTube. Even if you watching this, you're on some fucking technical device and you're making excuses. Do you know somebody got the nerve to comment an excuse on fucking Instagram? They have an iPhone with Google on it. They're texting me their excuse with their problem solver, their fucking phone. Think about it. You're texting me your excuse with your fucking problem solver. Your phone. Google the shit. You sitting here telling me what's not possible, and you could have texted all that shit in Google. You could have saved all that time and fucking said, Google, how do I make money? But you telling me what's not possible, what's not this, and you got a fucking phone and you're in America. You ain't even in Africa, where motherfuckers, they got genocide shit going over there. They got real war. People getting killed just because. People going through real shit around the world, and you got Americans with phones complaining every fucking day. Every day. The world is unfair. This is this. This is that. This is that. You feel me? So it's like that shit kills me with the excuses, with the I can't do this. I can't do this. I went to fucking Barnes and Nobles and bought all them fucking books myself. There's a Barnes and Nobles. There's Amazon. You know about all this shit. You Amazon yourself. Amazon wasn't originally a library who shipped books. You're ordering everything from Amazon except what the nigga started with. He started with books. Jeff Bezos was an online library. He'll ship the books to you. But you ordering every other Amazon package. You get your makeup kit, ladies. You get hella makeup from Amazon. Fellas, you get your game controllers, your memory cards, your fucking all your shit from Amazon except a book. Literacy is key. I'm telling you the power of books. It'll put your level. Do you know this? Let me explain something to y'all. And this for all my black people. All of you have been on planes before. We said we used to all, and you know, don't get me wrong, white people are privileged. But there is such thing as white privilege. But I will say this. When I'm on the airplane, we have our headphones on. They're reading books. You have to, at some point, give credit where it's due. We have our headphones on. They're reading books. If you taking a flight numerous times, you'll see what the fuck I'm talking about. So they have a different, I'll say this, because they're reading, they are going to be a lot more literate than we are. The race who reads becomes the Asian people. They're reading books. So we're complaining, but we're not getting smarter. They have a different literacy than we do. Understand what I'm saying. Why? Because they're reading more. It's a different mindset when you read. I'm telling you what's going on. Your imagination starts to, even if you're listening to audiobooks, putting in the information of literacy is key. So a lot of you listen to bullshit. You got to think, you force feed your brain with bullshit when that's all you think about. So now you're a bullshit thinker. Think about it. Look at the young men who only listen to rap music and who only look at world star hip hop and who only goddamn look at big booty bitches all day. Now he's a bullshit thinker. He's on the bullshit. It reflects in his swag. He dressed like the bullshit. He own the bullshit when he go to the club. Cause all he think about is bullshit. He force feed his brain all day that. So you become what you think every day. So I start to force. So you know what I did? I re-engineered my brain. Your brain is a muscle. You got to re-engineer that shit. You gotta re-engineer your brain into thinking financial literacy and getting money and believing in yourself. And not fucking with, it's just a whole, it's all about re-engineering what you believe in. That's why you gotta unlearn a lot of shit and relearn some shit. See, sometimes you gotta pull back after you leave mama house and say, let me research everything that they told me. The reason why I'm here today is because I questioned everything. Everything I had to pull out Google and research, read artifacts. I stopped becoming Christian because I did research. I figured out who wrote the book. How did we learn the religion? I am black. I was brought over here by Europeans. They force fed me the Bible. While we were on that boat, we were not Christians. So I stopped becoming Christians by doing simple math. Oh shit, I ain't even from here. I'm from over there. They took me over here on a boat. But when I was on that boat, I wasn't Christian. And then now my parents, my ancestors grew up in the South. The slave master gave them the Bible. Now he's a Christian. And then now I grow up a Christian because that's what I was brought into. Nope. I got to question that. This was forced on me. It wasn't my choice. I make the choice. When you become an adult, I gotta go make some choices now. I can't just accept what you give me. I don't care what it is. I ain't accepting what nobody give me. Unless I like it. And at some point, you gotta get to that point in life. What's your religion? I'm a spiritual person. I don't believe in one religion. I believe in the Most High. I believe in, you want to know what my religion is? If anything, I'm a Buddhist. I think Buddhists believe in the golden rule. Do unto others as you would want done to you. So if I was any religion, I'd probably be a Buddhist. I only believe in the golden rule. I believe if everybody sticks to the golden rule, everything would be okay. Why would you rape that little girl? Would you want somebody raping you if you was a little boy? Why would you shoot this person? Would you want somebody shooting you? Why would you scam this person? Would you want somebody doing that to you? If everybody lived by the golden rule, we wouldn't even need religion. If we focused on good karma, the Most High would bless us because we ain't doing nothing wrong. You feel me? So karma is really the religion I follow. I don't do anything to somebody that I wouldn't want done to myself. And honestly, if you just live by that, you'll go far in life. You feel me? That's just how this shit go. But nah, man, get money, man. Have fun, get money, be you. Allow people to be themselves. And another thing I gotta say too, shot RIP Nip. Nip said this. Nip said, we gotta start working on how we respond to disrespect. Right? And he said, you know, and that touched me. Cause he was like, a lot of times we react to disrespect so negatively. And he said, and Nip said that before he died in the interview. He said, we gotta work on how we respond to disrespect. And it's crazy because that's how he got killed. Because somebody responded to disrespect, or in their eyes that way, you know, allegedly. Right? So we don't know the story. You know, it's only the truth and whatever happened, right? But yeah, man, we got to start killing people with kindness too. That'll fix the world too sometimes. Just killing people with kindness. I feel like kindness don't hurt as much as that. I ain't gonna lie. Like, revenge is the sweetest joy. Revenge is the sweetest joy. It depends on what you do. But when you kill somebody, when it's minor shit and you kill people with kindness, it hurts their soul. You know what I'm saying? It hurts the fuck out their soul. It stings their heart. When you kill people with kindness over little shit though. You know, don't let the big shit slide. So, you know, a lot of you, Nip was different. Yeah, Nip was different. He was a different level of thinking. And it's funny because we don't appreciate people that much until they're gone. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, that's why it's important to appreciate people while you on earth. Because you got to think about this, folks. We're just a speck in time in the universe. So me and you are ancestors. 1,000 years from now, you're going to be somebody's ancestor, meaning your genes and everything will live on. And you know what I mean? So you are an ancestor. All of you are. This is just a speck in time. So you got to appreciate people while they're here, because we're all here temporarily. We're just a speck in the universe. This shit gonna go on when we're gone, y'all. Y'all do understand that, right? And then the only memories they gonna have is this right here. Social media, pictures, technology, archives. That's the only memory we have of each other now. Digitally. You get what I mean? We won't even have photo album books no more. Them shit's gone. Whoever the company who created those, they know they ain't getting no more money. I feel sorry for the Fobo album book creators. It's a lot of people who lost like money because of technology, for sure. So y'all gotta understand that too. That's why I ball hard. That's why I talk my shit on this earth. Cause I know I'm here temporarily. I'm not finna let you tear me down and humble me when I know for a fact that this shit gonna go on and on and on. So I'm gonna write my story. You can be scared to write yours, but don't get mad at me for writing mine. Cause guess what? We only live once. You feel me? We only live once. So I'm gonna write my story regardless of who don't like it. Cause you know what I'm saying? When this shit all said and done, when I sign out and you sign out, at least I tried, motherfucker. We all gonna sign out one day. But if you ain't try, Don't get mad at me. You feel me? Don't get mad at me. But yeah, 100 years from now, every last one of us will be gone. Every last one of us. 100 years from now. Just 100. None of us gonna live to no 120 or 119, 100 and none of us gonna live that goddamn long. Let's be honest. Let's just be honest. Just a century from now. And if we really being technical, a good 70 years from now. Because a lot of us ain't gonna get to no 99. So 70 years from now, we being technical. So I don't know why people thinking this shit forever. The only way it's forever is to have children. That's how you not die. Leaving a legacy. There's only one way to be immortal, and that's becoming an ancestor. That's the reason I had children young, because I understood that at a young age. I understood that, hey, I want to be immortal. As soon as I became a millionaire, the first thing I wanted to do was have a child. Because if I don't listen, when I became a millionaire, I thought it was important to have a child. Because if I die with all this money, where does this money go to? Somebody else who's not a creation of me? You didn't come out of my ball sacks. Why do you deserve what I have? It's to make sure what I work for matters. Without children, in my opinion, what you work for don't matter. You gonna die and that shit gone. You just working hard for what? So you can live life? So you can goddamn enjoy some what? Hell nah, I want this shit to matter. This work I'm doing, this hard work I'm doing. If I go, make sure this shit go to my ball sacks. That's how I feel. I don't want this shit going to my brother, my sister, my mother. Nah, hell nah, it's going to my goddamn ball sacks. Y'all lived y'all life. I'm gonna be immortal. I can never go. Because I have children. You get what I'm saying? So I'm gonna live on forever. As long as they have children. That's why it's important to teach your kids to have kids. It's going to my ball sacks. I'm sitting here talking shit. And I'm on the gas. Yeah. Thief. You ain't gonna say hi to my live? Something else. Go ahead. That's what we forget to pass down the wealth. I just had my kid 4 days ago. Facts. I only got two though. I might have a third one in the future. But right now, I got to go enjoy life. Now I'm being selfish. I don't want no more kids right now because I'm being selfish. I got a boy and a girl. So it's like I'm done having kids because I want to be, you know what I'm saying? I want to be able to travel still, see the world, you know, and save money and grow this legacy. Now, if I make $100 million, cool. I can go have some more kids. But right now, I can't afford more kids right now. I got two. And I can't, how am I going to get money for business if I got, you know what I'm saying, way too many kids. So I'm done for now. And if I make $100 million, I'll go have my third one. I gotta make a kid every, I do 50. I'll accept the 50. Third one on the 50. I don't know though. Can't do it right now. I gotta go do some shit. I gotta go to, I like it, and then I like the fact that we have a boy and a girl, so it's like we could be one and done. Oh yeah, when I make $100 million, yeah, when. I ain't gonna lie, I'm gonna generate $100 million over my lifetime. That's guaranteed. Now, if you want to know, Well, I won't say it's guaranteed, but at the rate, at the pace I'm going, it's guaranteed. And that's just honest truth. I will gross over 100 million in my lifetime. Guaranteed. You know. Thoughts on renting cars out? I mean, it's cool, but you also, you know, it's not my hustle. I don't like the liability of it. People don't take care of your stuff. And people, you'll start to find out how like weird people are. I'm not trusting anymore. Like, I start to realize that few people are like real genuine people. See, I came in the world naive. I came in the world thinking 90% of people were good and 10% were bad, because only a few kill. But actually, it's the other way around. 90% of people are on the bullshit, and about 10% of people aren't. It's actually backwards. And when you learn that as an adult, it's going to shock you. That's something all adults learn. But we all come into the world thinking the opposite. 90% of people cool and 10% are bad. And then you'll figure out it's the other way around. 90% of people are on the bullshit. Like, straight up will snake you, will fucking stab you in your back, will talk shit about you, will goddamn, I'm talking about, step all over you. 90%. And 10% won't. It's backwards, actually. Fucked up, huh? Fucked up, I know. That's why you got 100K impressions, but 5K likes. Because 90% of people on the bullshit. You get what I'm saying? 1,000 people saw it, but only 5 likes. Let me tell you why. Because I just told you, 90% of people on the bullshit. Is the proof is in the pudding there. You see it on social media. You get 50K views, but 1K likes. Why? Because 90% of people are on the bullshit. Haters. Don't want to see you win. Waiting on you to fall off. All that shit. You feel me? Yeah. Real shit. They said they really don't give a fuck. So when you learn that, it's going to make you move smarter in life. It's going to make you invest in things way better. They said absolute truth. How this shit go, man? Love the mic. Appreciate it. You like how you smoke? Hey, somebody like, he got to be high. He probably new to me. Do you think the bear market is over, Aristotle? Man, so much volatility. I don't know, bro. We probably coming right back to the bottom. Honestly, if we being honest, not even to the bottom, but like, we might make another pullback, but we keep making higher lows and higher highs, so it looking good. I just asked a question out of curiosity. Don't take the, I don't know what they talking about. I'm on the real one though. We on like the real live, talking that real shit. You know how it go. When you love yourself, negativity don't faze you. I fuck with Emperor Crew. Cool, man. I just got to go to your profile after this, just to check you out. Anybody I see frequently, I'm a fuck with. You feel me? I got to meet you in person, too. I'm a fan of whoever is a fan of me. You get what I'm saying? So the guy I just pinned, he fuck with me, so I fuck with him. I don't, you know what I'm saying? I actually want to meet all my stans. I don't think stans are crazy. Because you got to think, if Eminem would have goddamn, like, read the dude letter, Buddy probably would have goddamn, you know, been happy. He ain't want to, you know, go out bad or kill nobody. They just want to goddamn see you. So I feel like somebody fucking with me, I'm going to fuck with them. I don't think they mean harm. Facts, bro. You the realest. For sure. I fuck with all y'all, bro. I fuck with people. Now, granted, I know how to keep myself protected. I ain't on no dumb shit or no trusting shit. You get what I'm saying? I ain't that stupid. You get what I'm saying? But I fuck with people if they fuck with me. But I will say this, in the words of Diddy, sometimes you got to say fuck them too. You feel me? Like, I ain't going to lie to you, like. Or that song, you ever heard that song? You say, motherfuck me, nah, motherfuck you. I ain't gonna lie, that's been my mood for the first 26 years. But when I turn 27, which will be 7 days from now, I think I'm gonna switch it up. I think I'm gonna try killing people with kindness for once. Cause I used to have that goddamn, nah, fuck you too. I don't freestyle on people though. Like, I ain't gonna come at you first. If you say fuck me, it's fuck you too. You feel me? But now I'm on some like love and happiness, brother. You know, I'm trying to change this shit up. I'm trying to change this shit up for the first time in life. All right. For sure. Let me get this straight, brother. You're asking me, am I going to give up a stream of income that I have no boss, that makes me happy when I win, that, so he asked me, do you ever plan on retiring from trading? So once again, I have no boss. I'm happy when I win. It disciplines me and it challenges me. And if I learn this, I can always be financially free and nobody can never take anything away from me. Meaning like the job can fire me. Mark Zuckerberg can hate and take down my Instagram. You know, anything can happen. But as long as I can trade, I'll always have money. Call me what you want, but you can't call me broke. You feel me? Call me what you want, but you can't call me broke. By the way, comment mentor if you want to learn. And by the way, I'm going to drop the link in my bio. But if not, go to honeydripnetwork.com. I repeat, go to honeydripnetwork.com and you can go purchase my collab mentorship where I guarantee we will teach you the tools to be profitable in trading and on your way to profitability. So I will give you all the tools. The only thing I need you to work on is discipline and patience. So I will teach you the strategies, but I can only teach you risk management and A-plus setups. So what I'm going to teach you is, for one, what does it take to become a profitable trader? You need risk management, learning how to risk your money and manage your money. And then number two, A-plus setups, meaning high probability setups, things that work 90 to 80% of the time. So we're going to teach you the setups that work 90 to 80% of the time. So what does this mean? For instance, I'll tell you a setup, a bull flag, right? Or a bear flag, bull and bear flags. So this setup, particular setup, if you play this one setup, right? If you play this one setup 100 times, you will win 80 to 85% of the time. I tell people that. I just told y'all. If you, the bull and bear flag, if you play that setup correctly, you will literally hit 80 of them out of 100 times. But you got to learn how to identify them. You got to research them, right? So what we have is about, I'll say a good 20 of them that I have, 20 high probability setups. 20 of them. That's what I have. And my team has, we have a lot of them. So we teach that, and then discipline. So if you comment mentor, you will be able to get in our mentorship. It is $770. Not the people on YouTube. YouTube, I'll drop the link. I'll try to drop the link right now, as a matter of fact. Hold up. I'll try to find the link. It is, let me go to honeydripnetwork.com, and I'll drop it right here. Let me go to mentor. And then, but the people on Instagram got to comment mentor. So I'll drop it in the comments here. For the people in the comments. Boom. All right. There it go. If you want to join that, people on YouTube. Oh, that's hard. YouTube letting you drop comments. Let's go. So I dropped it in the YouTube comments. And then the people on Instagram comment mentor. So we're going to teach you through a 6-week program, right? We're going to keep accountability of your progress. So it's going to, so for all of you, like, will I be left behind? This is a mentorship, meaning we're going to literally keep progress of your progress, right? So our job is to make sure you learn trading in those 6 weeks. And let me tell you, let me explain how. It's going to be 6 weeks, right? Week one, training, the beginner's training. Week two, the intermediate training. Week three, the expert training. And then week four, all of the hidden gems and the strategies. And then week five is where we do the recaps. So we go trading recaps. So now we're doing the trading recaps, and you're allowed to ask us questions. The floor is yours for literally 30 minutes to an hour. Well, really, it's going to be about an hour. The floor is yours. So for a whole hour, we'll be breaking down anything y'all want to learn. So all of us, we're going to take turns breaking down anything y'all want to learn or you missed out on. Okay, so you got to ask her. So you get 6 times to do that, though. So we're going to go through, we're going to literally make sure you have, you can't say, hey, he didn't answer my question, he didn't do this, he didn't do that, because we're going to do it 6 times. And if I don't answer your question, chances are somebody else asked the same thing. So there's not going to be no, hey, you didn't answer my question, you didn't do nothing, you didn't do this, you didn't do that. You got 6 times. And we put you through 8 live trainings in Zooms and a Q&A after that. So you really had about, what, 6 plus 8? 14 times to ask us questions and to reiterate on what happened and to make sure you get it. 14 times, actually. So mentor, comment mentorship, if you're on Instagram, if you want to join it, and comment and join and hit the link in the bio. You have more call put options set for tomorrow before the holiday weekend? Hell nah. I'm going cash. What do you recommend investing in the stock market or day trading? I'm really trying to do both. I don't know what I should start doing first. I don't know. Somebody said, I bought the course a while back. It's worth it. Y'all see that? Look at that. Pin that comment. What's up, bro? Do you think the market is a weird place right now? I'm day trading, bro. Somebody said, are you high? Is you rolling? Is you rolling? Is you rolling? Is you rolling? Bitch, I might be. Bitch, I might be. Hey, boy, he geeked up. Bro, he geeked up. Bro, he geeked up. Bro, he geeked up. Bitch, I might be. Hey, we gotta play that shit. That's my song.
Hey. We gotta play that shit. Yeah, hell yeah. Hey.
We come to the club. We got the choppers on deck and the yappers on deck. Is you rolling? Bitch, I might be.
Hey. Bitch, I might be. Let's go. Somebody said, and copyright. Right. He said, homie, forget about the topic. Hey, man, let's get it. They asked me, was I high, man? Bitch, I might be. He said, nah, you fried for sure. How old was you when this came out?
I don't know. Oh, yeah, let's see. Boy, I probably was goddamn
14.
But see, 13
years ago. So I'm 26. Yeah, I was 14 when this shit came out. Told you. I be knowing when shit come out. I was a young savage. I listened to everything. R&B, hip hop, trap music, everything. He said, bro, higher than high. He in Astroverse. Think about that, y'all. I only smoke this. Just, this is how much I smoke. And I'm high as shit. That's why I smoke out the bowl, because you actually save more weed. So it's more concentrated. So I'm getting higher than the dude who off the blunt. And I only put in maybe half a gram of weed. I only smoke half a gram of weed. And I'm high. And it's not even all the way burnt yet. I still could keep burning it. So bowls get you higher. That's why I smoke out of bowls, because I save more weed. So now I don't have to buy a lot of weed. Like, I used to buy like an ounce would probably last me 2 months smoking out of a bowl, where an ounce would last me like 2 weeks smoking blunts. You get what I'm saying? So that's why I smoke out of the bowl. Yeah, and it's a low tolerance. You feel me? What strand? I'm smoking Sour Diesel. I pulled out a classic today. Because every time I go overseas, them dudes be asking me, are you smoking Sour Diesel? So I'm like, bro, I never had Sour Diesel. So I called up the I said, bro, go get me the real one. But like the one. Go get me the Sour Diesel these dudes talking about. I don't want the one where a dude lied and said it was this. Nah, go to the actual real people and go get that for me. And I went and got it. So I pulled out a classic. See, I like to smoke the real ones. Like, you know how, like, if somebody say it's a good strand of weed out there, I'll literally go get it. Like, if I hear it's a good strand of weed, I'm going to go get it. I'm going to research it and go find it. Like, I'm not going to listen to no dude off the street telling me this, that. They be lying. If you don't know that, that's the cap. That's the real game. Your weed man lying to you. He not giving you the real one. I done smoked the real ones before. Like Gorilla Glue. Some of you never smoked the real Gorilla Glue. I smoked the real Gorilla Glue. You know what I'm saying? That shit is amazing. It's this shit called Orange 45. Shit is amazing. Y'all gotta smoke like the real ones. You gotta smoke real runts. Like the real runts. I done smoked the real runts.
Real shit. He said, this shit so fucking funny, bro. I done smoked the real runts. I done smoked the real Kim Brulee. For sure. Hey, don't fuck, man. Hey, I fuck with it. You feel me? Northern Lights, real fire. I gotta go see what's going on. I heard I gotta go get that Northern Lights. That boy said AK-47. Shit be like digging for gold. Nah, I do, bro. Talk to Cali shit. I ain't gonna lie, them Cali boys smoking better than everybody, though. I'll be honest with you. Like, if you live, with the exceptions of dudes who smoking in, who from California, and I ain't talking about y'all. Y'all got the real one. Like, them boys who in Seattle, California, Chicago, I give all y'all credit. In Colorado. Colorado, Seattle, California. Them boys got the real one. I heard Oklahoma got the real one too, but I don't know. I heard them Oklahoma boys got it. It's Oregon, bro. LA, we get our best strands. Oregon too, yeah. Yeah, Vegas ain't got the gas. Vegas got that tourist gas. Vegas for like old white people. It's not the strain, it's the grower. I think so. What type of advice is that? Arizona too. Now let's get back to today's topic. I'm sorry, I was goddamn hearing some noise. I think that's music. Cali, Colorado, Seattle, Chicago, Atlanta, Vegas. Cali, Colorado, Seattle, Chicago, 5, Atlanta, 6, Vegas. Atlanta got good weed, but like, you can't get it off the streets. You gotta get it from like the actual person. You gotta know somebody. You can get it off the streets, but like, you gotta know somebody with it. You had QQQ puts today, or you missed? Nah, hell no, I ain't had no QQQ puts. All right, you recommend Robinhood for swing trading? I ain't gonna lie, I'm about to get off this shit. I'm about to goddamn go and do some other shit. God bless y'all. I spent a lot of time. This is Aristotle, episode 3, and this is High Thoughts. Real shit, we got high as fuck. We had fun. And God bless y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed this TED Talk. I hope y'all get a lot of gems from this shit, because we talked a lot of good shit, for sure. I can't wait to see the replay on this. But God bless y'all. All right, we finished the broadcast on YouTube. And if y'all want to see this replay, y'all got to get it off YouTube. So if y'all want to see this replay, get it off YouTube. That's the only way you're going to get it, all right?